everyone. Welcome back to the channel. So today's video was originally going to be titled, I'm a Perfectionist and the Tiny or Really Big Ways I'm Letting It Ruin My Life. But in just the last couple days since I planned it until now, I've had a revelation about what perfectionism really is and what it means to me and how that's going to affect the way I look at it from here on out. So while today's video is still going to be about perfectionism, it's not quite the same as what I had originally thought about talking about. So I hope you'll come along with me to find out what in the world I'm talking about. Please, if you're enjoying my videos, subscribe to the channel. I'd love to have you join the community and give this video a thumbs up. Probably dying to know what the heck I mean by what I said that I'm looking at perfectionism differently. The first thing I want to say is I was recently introduced to the idea that perfectionism is a construct of an institutional system which is designed to maintain the status quo. It is designed not to help the individual, but rather to maintain the system in which it lives. That being said, it's extremely detrimental to the individual people. This really resonates with me because I've always looked at myself as a perfectionist, and I've always kind of seen that as a deficit to my character. In fact, in those good old interviews where they ask you, like, what is one weakness of yours, I constantly said perfectionism because I always viewed it as a weakness, a personal weakness, and it was something that you could spin in those like positive ways, like I'm working on it, this is the way I've been a perfectionist in the past and how I'm improving in it. So I've always attributed it to me personally. But this new viewpoint that perfectionism isn't a personal defect, so to say, but a construct of the systems that we live in, has changed the way I look at it, and I do believe it's going to change the way that I approach it in the future. And this kind of has pretty big implications for me personally as I move through this grad school journey. My plan for this video is to walk you through a couple examples of the way that perfectionism has impacted my life and how I am going to think about this moving forward to change the way my past behavior has been to hopefully help me be more successful in the future. The first relatable, way that I would like to introduce it is me taking forever to start this channel and this blog. I have been thinking about and wanting to start a blog since I started my master's journey. Getting my master's was a huge step for me in my life, and I really wanted to share it with people. And I even did a ton of research a few years ago into it, but I constantly let perfectionism stand in my way. I didn't ever think that what I had to say was going to be perfect enough for people to want to hear it. I didn't think that I was perfect enough. Like, of course I'm not perfect, but part of me said that I wasn't going to be perfect enough to be relatable or to give good enough advice or to even share my own journey, which is crazy because it's my journey that I'm sharing. These also all play a role into imposter syndrome, which I am not going to go into this video, but imposter syndrome, perfectionism, all this feeling of inadequacy really just goes together so well. so think about that. It took me a really long time to get this started. I have really pushed to get it started now for my PhD journey because I guess my desire overcame my drive for perfectionism. And now, as I'm looking at perfectionism differently, I think I'm overcoming that even more. I will say posting my very first video on this channel was nerve-wracking, and I never thought it was perfect enough to be posted, but I do value growth and I value challenges, and I hope that, I mean, I feel that I've already learned so much. I've made like 6 videos now. This is my 6th or 7th. And I feel like from where I started on that number 1 to now, I've already seen a tremendous amount of growth and I can only see more. So I don't think anymore that getting a perfect product from Go is realistic and it's just detrimental to life. With that being said, the second scenario that I want to share with you that's more relatable to grad school, undergrad, is procrastination as a product of perfectionism. I continually, through undergrad and even into grad school, would procrastinate on assignments because anytime I finished an assignment ahead of time, I would obsess about it not being perfect, and I would spend so much time analyzing it and going over it and changing it in ways that then kind of sometimes detracted from its value. I obsessed about that perfection. But on the flip side, when I would procrastinate and finish it last minute, I didn't have time to obsess about perfection because I was only obsessing about getting it done on time. And then I had this like weird reward because I did well on those assignments that I procrastinated, which was not good for me at all because it just fed that procrastination cycle. But what I realized is that perfectionism was driving that. And instead of procrastinating entering grad school now, I am committed to keeping a schedule, completing assignments ahead of time, so that I can get feedback from the right people on those assignments to improve them. And I can also look at it when I'm reviewing them and not obsess about perfection, but growth. Growth from one assignment to the next, growth throughout the semester. So the second scenario that I want to talk about that is really relevant to graduate school was my experience with my master's research project. During my master's research project, spent an exorbitant amount of time planning my research project. I was trying to plan exactly what I was going to do every day, during every week, and in the same vein, predict outcomes that would affect further downstream work and plan for those, so that I could have my entire research planned out and be perfect. This, if you know anything about scientific research, is a horrible idea, because in the process of doing scientific research, especially if you're doing like cutting edge, new, trying to find new discoveries, trying to plan how everything can really negatively affect it in a number of ways. It leaves you unopened to exploring new discoveries. For example, if something early in your plan creates new knowledge that you weren't previously aware of, then that new knowledge should direct further research. But if you have this plan that you prescribe as perfect and you're not going to deviate from that plan, then it really detracts from the knowledge you gain along the way and the growth you should find along the way. And also, I spent way too much time with this plan when I could be spending that time actually doing the research and actually having that growth. This is something that I, as a first-time researcher during my master's, didn't really understand, and also something that I didn't really talk about with my research advisor, which I wish I would have, But it's something that I grew in and learned in throughout the process, and something I'm going to be using for my PhD thesis research. Is just that knowledge that, yes, it's okay to have a plan. In fact, it's good to have a plan, but the plan doesn't need to be perfect from start to finish. And there's really going to be, hopefully, growth along the way. You may learn something new along the way that changes the plan. And while I think that thinking ahead and having forward thinking and even having those hypotheses is great, you should never be like so stuck in that plan that you are not willing to see the information you're getting from more of the beginning stages. So this is just something that I've learned about scientific research, and I've learned about how being in a perfectionist system can like affect me in that way. So that is definitely a huge, huge, huge way that I'm looking to change for graduate school. The last way that perfectionism has impacted my life has been more of a broad impact. It's impacted my school career, my career after school. It's also impacted my like future decisions, and that has been the idea that because of my perfectionism, I have avoided doing work that I didn't feel I could do perfectly or be perfect in. For example, if I had a task to complete at work that I didn't think I could do perfectly, I would try and push it off until the last minute. Or if I had something in school, an assignment that I didn't think I could do perfectly, I would spend a lot of time researching it and researching how to do it and research until all of a sudden it was last minute and it just had to get done. Often in those situations, all the research went to waste because I was in such a time crunch to get it done that I wasn't able to really use the research I had done previously. The really kind of sad thing as I think about this now is how I wasn't like leaving room for growth for myself in the process. And I think growth and learning from yourself as you go is so important. It's more important to me now than being perfect. I think that there are things that we can ascribe to, but the standard of perfectionism is just this like unattainable goal almost that holds me back more than it pushes me forward. And I'm beginning to realize that in a new way, even beyond, like I said, it being a personal deficit, but just kind of like a construct that I need to break through. So as I move forward through grad school, I am going to be really focusing on my growth and my learning and not being perfect every second of the day. Asking more questions, getting it wrong sometimes, and learning how to accept when I am wrong and allow that information to help me get better. As you might have noticed, also, my perfectionism and procrastination have gone hand in hand. I know a lot of times when I talk to other graduate students, procrastination is a huge issue. And for a number of people that I've talked to, we've been able to link the procrastination with perfectionism. It's not always the case. Definitely look at your own personal situation. There are many reasons why people procrastinate, but think about for you if it is because of perfectionism. And maybe some of the things I've said that you relate to, you can think about with your journey and how it can help you grow. I hope that this video has been exciting for you. Please give it a thumbs up if you like it. Please comment below what you found resonated with you most, or if you have examples of perfectionism, how you feel about this topic. And also, please consider subscribing to the channel. I would really love to build a community and see it grow, and I hope that you will be a part of that community. So until the next time, I'll see